Hello kids, good morning. How are you? Are you all fine? Okay, I think you are all enjoying your online classes, right? You're very much interested in online classes, is it? Okay, so in our previous class we studied a poem, ABC poem, right? So are you all thorough with the previous portion? Is it? Okay, very good. So if you haven't completed studying, studied, okay? Okay, so we have already skipped a portion, right? Vocabulary and pronunciation from unit 1, right? So today we are going to see that, okay? So in vocabulary and pronunciation, today we are going to see first about personification, okay? So what is personification? Shall we study? Yeah, here it is. So person, who is a person? A person, a human, right? So personification means the process of giving human qualities to animals or objects, okay? So we have certain qualities, right? Humans, we have certain qualities which other objects don't have, right? For example, crying, this is human qualities, right? We humans used to cry, right? Yeah, then laughing, dancing. So these are some human qualities, right? So giving this human qualities to some animals or objects, okay? So when we see the example, you will be clear about it, okay? So shall we see? Okay, here is the first example which is given in your book, okay? The grass wept in pain when a little boy walked on them. Okay, see, I'm reading it again. The grass wept in pain when a little boy walked on them. So here what's given is the wept means crying, okay? Crying. So the grass is crying in pain when the little boy walked on. So when a little boy is walking on the lawn or in a garden, he's just stamping the grass, okay? So it is said here, the grass is weeping or the grass is crying. So will the grass cry? No, right? But we humans cry, right? We weep, right? So it's given here, the grass is crying or weeping, wept, okay? So they are saying like that, okay? So the wept or weeping is the human quality, right? So giving this human quality to the grass, an object, okay? So to some other thing, okay? So that is personification. So the word here, wept is here, no? This is the word which is used to personify this grass, okay? Do you understand? Okay, now let's see another one example. The wind whistled throughout the day. So do you know whistle? How to whistling? Whistling. Do you know how to whistle? Yes, many of you may know, right? So here it's given, the wind whistled throughout the day. So will the wind whistle? No, right? But humans know to whistle, right? Yeah, but it said here, the wind is whistling. The sound of the wind is compared or said as whistling sound, okay? So the human quality that is whistling, that is said to what? The sound of the wind, okay? So here this word is personification, okay? So we personify the wind with the word whistle, okay? Do you understand? Okay, so shall we move to the next example? Yes. Yeah, here, the sun played peekaboo with the clouds. The sun played peekaboo with the clouds. So what's mean by peekaboo? Like hide and seek, okay? Hide and seek. Yeah, you all know, right? Used to play, right? Yeah. So the sun played peekaboo with the clouds. Will the sun play? No, right? But when the clouds are moving, sometimes the sun may be hidden on the clouds, right? So to say that, just to enhance or just to give beauty to that sentence, they are using the word, the sun played peekaboo with just when the clouds are moving, sometimes the sun may hide, okay, but it won't play. But we are giving the human qualities, that is peekaboo, which is the hide and seek which is usually common in kids or human qualities, right? We used to play that. So they are giving this word to sun and the clouds. Okay, so this is personification. Okay, do you understand? Shall we move to the next one? Yes. The flame of the candle danced in the dark. Listen carefully. The flame of the candle danced in the dark. Will the candle flame dance? No, right? But you people know dancing, right? You will dance? No. Yeah, we humans used to dance, right? Will the candle flame dance? No. But why they are saying the candle is, the flame is dancing? It's because when a wind blows, the flame will move here and there, right? You might have seen, right? Have you seen? Yes, very good. Okay, so when the wind is blowing, sometimes this candle flame may move here and there. Just to say that the candle flame is moving, they are using the words as danced. Okay, just to give beauty to the word, okay? So they are using dance, but the dancing is human quality, right? Yes, but they have given this human quality dance to the object, okay? So do you understand? Giving the quality, human quality, to some other object is called personification. Okay, shall we move to the next one? Shall we move? Okay, very good. Next one. The leaves danced their way through the lawn. The leaves danced their way through the lawn. Yeah, you know, right? So lawn means a garden. Okay, some green grass will be there, no, that area, okay, lawn area, okay, filled with the grass. So here they are saying the leaves dance their way through the lawn. Actually, the leaves are not dancing. What they are doing, when the wind is blowing, they are moving. Okay, that's it. But they are giving the word danced for the movement of the leaves. But will the leaves dance? No, right? But humans, we used to dance. So giving the human quality to the object or the leaves is called personification. Do you understand, ma? Do you have any doubt? So if you have any doubt, you just call me, okay? So I will give you the PDF, no? So in the worksheet, I have given the book exercise, okay? So you have to know what's it. Okay, just listen to me, okay? I am just reading the heading and I will give you a small just how to do the worksheet, okay? And then we shall move to the next one. So underline the words, page number 15, okay, ma? Page number 15. Underline the words in the given sentences that personify animals or non-living things. Okay, they have said to underline the words which personify animals. So the exercise which is given, you should do that. But I am giving the example. See here in the sentence, the leaves, right? You have seen here, right? The leaves. See here, the leaves, they are given, the leaves danced through their way through the lawn. So the word dance, see here, this is the word which is personifying the animal, sorry, the leaves. Okay, so whatever may be, animals are non-living things. The words, you have to underline the word which is personifying the object. Okay, so here the leaves is the object, but the word which personify the leaves is dance. So you have to underline dance. Okay, likewise, there are few questions, maybe 5 questions, I think so. So you have to answer that questions. Okay. Okay. Do you all understand? Okay. So shall we move to the next part? Shall we? Okay. Okay. Okay, the next topic we are going to see is pronunciation. Okay, you all know, right? Pronunciation means how to pronounce the word words, right? Yeah, so we are going to see pronunciation. SH words, okay? SH words, words with ish sound. This SH means we used to say is sh, right? Yeah, with words with sh sound. Okay, SH, okay? Shall we see? Okay, see here. Here are some words which are beginning with that ish sound, okay? SH, okay? SH words. So, SH means, words means we have to pronounce it as sh, okay? So, see here. What is this? How will you read this word? Read it with me. Shadow. So, SH for SH, you are using the sound sh, right? Shadow, right? Okay, see the next word. What is this? Shoulder. Show. Sh. Sh sound is there, no? Shoulder. The next one. Shout. What's it? Shout. Then, shop. Sheep. Share. So these are few words which we are using for the sound ish, okay? So do you all understand? So these are few words which are starting with the sound ish, okay? So shall we move to the next one? Yeah, then here we are going to see some words where there is ish sound in the sound in the middle, okay? So see here, bushes. So the sh sound is in the middle, right? In between, okay? So bushes. Bushes. Then this is dishes. Fishing. Pushing. Flashlight. Cushion. Is it? So you all know this words, right? So why do the ish sound comes? In between, right? In middle. Okay. So shall we see the next one? So here we are going to see some words where we have the ish sound on the last part, okay? So the last, okay? See here, brush. So the ish sound comes on the last, right? Brush. Dish. Cash. Eyelash. Splash. Trash. Leash. So you all know these words, right? Brush. Dish. Cash. Eyelash. Splash. Trash, leash. So these are the few words where the sh sound comes on the last. Yes, sh comes on the last part. Okay. So next, what we are going to see is there are few words for which we give sh sound for ch. Okay. Sometimes the word may start or end with wherever it may be ch. This letter will come. Okay. So first we studied where there is the letter SH, we used to say it as ish sound, right? Yeah. Now we are going to see some words where there is the letter as CH, but we are going to pronounce it as ish sound, okay? Sha sound, okay? Do you understand? There are few words where there is CH letter, but we are pronouncing that CH letter as SH. But usually when we see this CH, we used to pronounce it as ch, right? For example, much, M-U-C-H, much. CH, ch, right? And then when you see about church, C-H-U-R-C-H, starting with CH, but we whether we will say church or church, we used to say church, right? So, ch sound. But here, there are few words where we use ish sound for ch. Okay, let us see the words only for few sounds, words, not for all words. Okay, see here, champagne. This is not champagne. Okay, champagne. Okay, this is chef or chef. Yeah, you should pronounce it as chef. Okay, not chef. So by seeing the ch, you should not use the word chef. This is chef. Okay. And the next one, brochure. Okay, not brochure, brochure. Okay, we are giving ish sound for CH in this words. Okay, not for all words, but for some words. Then here, what is it? Machine or machine? Machine, right? So we are giving ish sound for CH. The next one, parachute or parachute? It's parachute, right? So we are giving ish sound for CH. Okay. Okay, these are few words. Okay, now shall we move to the next? Yeah, here it is. It is T-I-N-C-I-S, Iskach. First we studied Iskach sound, that is ish sound. Some words starting and ending or in between, okay, is with ish sound. And then we studied CH as Iskach. Some CH words which is pronounced as Iskach. Okay, do you understand? Now we are going to see some words with the T-I-N-C-I which is pronounced as SH. That means sh sound. Okay? Do you understand? Now we are going to see the words which has T-I and C-I as ish sound. Okay? See here some words with the T-I. Okay? A-C-T-I-O-N. T-I is there. Did you see ma? T-I. So how will you pronounce this? Acten or action? Action, right? Yes, you are very good. Action, action. But T-I is there. But we are pronouncing it as ish. Action, shun, right? Ish sound, okay? And see here the next word. It is mention or mention? Yes, it's mention. Okay, so here in between we can see T-I. But how do we pronounce it? As mention, sha sound, ish sound, right? And now cautious. This is cautious or cautious? It's cautious, right? Yes. But here the spelling, it's given as T-I-C-A-U-T-I-O-U-S. Here is given as T-I, right? It's given as T-I, cautious. It's given as T-I, but how do we pronounce it? Cautious. Okay. Now shall we move to the next one? And here words spelt with C-I. Okay, so there are few words where there is C-I but we pronounce it as sh sound. Okay. Yeah, here are the words. Musician. Musician or musician? Musician, right? Yeah, here the word. Sorry, the letter C-I is here. But how do we pronounce? Musician, right? Sh sound is there. Musician. And the next one. What is this? Special or special? Special, right? C-I is here, but in this way, S-P-E-C-I-L, S-P-E, special, shell, special. We are giving like that, right? The next word, delicious. Delicious or delicious? We won't say it as delicious. We say it as delicious, right? Ish sound. Okay, but here the spelling is C-I. But how do we pronounce it? How do we pronounce it? Delicious, right? Do we understand? Okay, now the next part. So there are some exceptions. Okay, not only the words which the letters T-I, C-I, C-H and S-H are pronounced as sh sound, in sh sound. But there are few exceptions. Okay, for example, see here. What's this? Read it. What's it? Sugar, right? S-U-G-A. We will say it as sugar or sugar. Sugar, right? Yeah, but here see the spelling. Is there T-I? No. C-I? No. C-H? No. S-H? No. But why do we say it as sugar? These are some exceptions. Okay? Yeah, but we have to pronounce it as sugar. Okay? Then here, tissue. See, you can see here, there are two S, right? Double S is there. But we should say it as tissue. Okay, these are some exceptions. Okay, for such words, there is no T-I, C-I, or C-H or S-H, but we have to pronounce it as ish, in ish sound. Okay, then see here, ocean. Okay, ocean. No C-I, T-I, or S-H or C-H, but ocean, sha sound is there. Okay, and then compassion. Okay, do we understand? Can you get me? Okay, okay. So this is okay. This is only this much. I'll tell you the exercise. I'll just explain you the exercise. Okay, not okay. Wait. Yes, I have given you in the worksheet the exercise from page number 17. Okay, so you have to complete the sentences using SH words. Okay, so for the fourth question, that is in page number 17. You have to complete the sentences using SH words. Okay. So, where you should take the SH words means the page number 16. Okay. In page number 16, you have so many SH words. Okay. According to the sentence, you have to take some SH words from page number 16. There are many sketch words, okay? So you can take some sketch words from page number 16, okay? From there you can take few words and write it, okay? And then for complete this paragraph using sketch words given in the box, okay? So the next one, for this exercise, in the box, okay, they have given the words. You, for this exercise, you have to use from the box which is given, okay? Do you understand? So if you have any doubt, you can call me, okay? No problem, you can call me and you can clarify my doubt, your doubt, okay? No problem, you can call me, okay? Okay, so after completing this worksheet, you have to send me the snapshot, okay? Don't forget to send me, okay? Don't forget, yes? Okay, so we shall meet on the next class, okay? Thank you. Bye-bye.